here. I'm a urological cardiologist working in Cauvery Hospital, Chennai. Yeah, heart failure is, in general, we can say it's a pump failure. Okay, pump failure means whenever the body meets the demand, heart is unable to produce the supply demand to that demand. That is called a heart failure. And like we can say like ejection failure or various name. In India, it is common in patients, those who are with existing diseases like previous MI or some heart defects or some other cardiomyopathies or some comorbidities like hypertension or diabetes, arrhythmia related, tachycardia related. These are the common cause of heart failure in India. Among those who are having existing heart disease, they will fall into this category. In heart failure, which we can stage it like a class 1, class 2, class 3, as we all know. Under risk of developing heart failure. Okay. Yeah, I have already told that the patients, those who are with existing heart disease, like recent MI, like some cardiomyopathies, comorbidities like hypertension, prolonged hypertension, diabetes, and some kidney issues, like tachycardia related cardiomyopathies, and untreated MIs like. Without taking any proper medications, not under the treatment for a long time, they will all produce heart failure for 80-85%. Yeah, recently diagnosed patients, they must know they are like they can't do all the routine exercises like others do. Just they have to keep in mind like lifestyle modifications, like if they smoke, then they have to quit smoking, and alcohol intake they have to give up, and routine medications like newer drugs newer drugs, they have to use it. They have come under that newer drug categories. You know, they have to take their medicines without any delay or without any missing dose, missing the doses. And for lifestyle modification, like high, they have to eat healthy. They have to do their exercise like minimally active. And whatever they have like previously, like symptoms like sort of the easy fatigue, they know it previously, so they have to aware of all these symptoms. Then they should not do all exercises which are producing these symptoms and aggravating these symptoms, which will lead to hospitalization again and again. So they have to be the they have to aware of like newer drugs. Which is like we have all certain sagubitril, the tarnies, and lifestyle modification. Of course, they have to give up all the bad habits like smoking, alcohol, and high protein diet, high fiber diet. That's all. Reduced salt intake and reduced fluid intake, such as that's all. Yeah, my message to them is do not skip their doses, like life-saving medicines. Do not miss those things which can reduce your rehospitalization, and check your diabetes and keep your diabetic under control. and check your hypertension and take the proper medications and adjust your medications. And check your heart for every 3 to 6 months. And the heart failure blood test, we all know that NT-proBNP. We can check and adjust the medications according to that blood test. And of course, follow-up, OP follow-up, regular follow-up with lifestyle modification, whatever I told in the previous question. We can newer medical management, like newer drugs, we can apply those newer drugs on them, and we can reduce the rehospitalization. And of course, lifestyle modification is very important. Again and again, I'm saying dose adjustment is particular. Dose adjustment, whatever the patient, the tolerance, we have to check the tolerance, and we have to apply the doses, appropriate doses, and regular OP follow, and regular diet. That's all, I think.